Hey, what's going on, everybody? Question. Have you ever been in a situation where you've been talking to someone and you realize that you're not really feeling them in that way, but unfortunately, you can tell that they've taken a liking to you and now you're trying to decide what to do next? I recently received a lot of emails asking, how do I deal with this situation when someone likes me, but I'm just not feeling them in that way? So here's the thing, my tidbit, keep it pushing. Be honest about it, all right? There comes a time where you will be definitely feeling that strain and stress of like, okay, what do I do next? I'm not really feeling you. Oh my God, what? Tell them, be honest, be truthful. Yes, it might hurt, it might sting, it might bust the other person's ego, but at least you're being honest about it. There is a, how do I say it? There is a tactfulness in doing so. You know, you don't have to be mean or you don't have to be rude, but you do want to get your point across. So I've noticed what happens with some people I've talked to, kind of helping them through this. I've told them, hey, just go up. If you feel comfortable with talking to this person, just be honest about it. Hey, I spent a lot of time with you. I really enjoy your company, but I just don't see us going that way. You know, unfortunately, that's just how I feel. Now, it's up to the other person, and don't worry about it on how they deal with it, because you're being honest and you know, if they come back and they're just like, wow, well, I didn't see you in that way anyways, that's just them being defensive, you know, or their ego must have been busted. And let it be. But be honest about it. Let them deal with how they feel afterwards. You know, it's only fair that you're being honest with yourself and you're being honest with them. I've noticed also, which is kind of funny, that ladies, a lot of ladies I've noticed, don't take this as a time to see if a guy is gonna follow through. If you tell a guy, I'm not really interested in you, don't expect him to be so persistent, all right? I'm telling this right now, it's just not fair for you to play that game of like, I'm not gonna deal with you, but then wonder why, okay, why isn't he giving me any more attention? This isn't the time to play that game of being, you know, let the guy be persistent in chasing you. Be honest about it. You know, if you like the dude, tell the dude, hey, let's see where this goes, you know. But if you don't like the dude, be straightforward. Tell the guy, this isn't the time where I'm trying to have you be persistent after me. I just don't see you in that way, right? Guys, you know, when it comes to ladies, be a little bit more delicate about it, but be cool about it. You know, be honest. I know some of my friends are very straightforward and they're just like, I ain't feeling you. That's just what it is. All right, and they don't care. But for other guys, you know, you want to be nice. You want to just tell them, hey, I love to be friends with you, but, you know, it's not, I don't see it the way it's going to be. You know, I don't see us going that route. I hope you really understand. If the girl acts up and she's kind of just pissed off, then, hey, it's off your hands, you know? I've been telling some people lately, if it gets to the point where, you know, the person is really persistent and you're really not feeling them and you just want to, like, be done with it, here's, I think, the biggest ego buster, especially for guys. Ladies, if you tell the dude who's being very persistent, damn, you know, you're such a great friend. You're like the brother I never had. That's like the biggest ego bust, I believe, when a guy's pursuing a girl and we hear, damn, she sees me as a brother. Because then it's kind of awkward, like, oh my gosh, she sees me like a family member, and now here's me dating a girl who thinks I'm like her big brother. Awkward, right? So ladies, do that. I personally used that before. I've done the whole, dang, you're like the sister I never had. And it really got the girl off my back. And unfortunately, I had to do that just because, you know, sometimes you got to break that ice. When they don't understand or they don't listen, they don't want to listen because they're so focused on their agenda. You just got to do that. So, you know, I've used the tactic of, sorry, you know, you're such a great friend. You're like the sister I've never had before. And I'm an only child, so I added this in there. This is how it feels to have a sibling, huh? Wow, you're such a great sister to me. And that like kills everything. So let me know what you guys think. I think it's a funny topic, but it's true. You know, there's times where people are really into you and you're just not feeling them. And you know, I wanna know how people have dealt with this. So reply back, video back, let me know. Please share your thoughts, your comments, and what you've done in order to kind of just alleviate the fire and push on. I know some people may have ran away with the situation and they just like wash their hands free and they don't want to deal with the person, so they just kind of not talk to them, not text them, not message them, not follow through with anything. But there's a respect value that I come with, and if I'm not feeling someone, I'm gonna tell them. I'm gonna let them know. So let me know what you guys think. Let me know what you guys have done. Hit me up below, comment. You know the email, melodicmike@gmail.com. Some of you guys have been asking, hey, what's up with the music? I'm waiting for my producer to finish, all the little things that he has to do, all the engineering part of it, and then send me my music. So until then, be patient. Thank you very much for being so patient. And pass this on forward to everybody you know. I'm getting new people subscribing, and I love it because people are starting to feel comfortable sending me emails on, asking for advice and stuff like that. And you guys know this channel is all about just giving advice and me helping out more people in this world. So thank you so much for being so supportive. And let me know what's good with you. All right. So until next time, stay blessed, and I will be back soon. Cheers.